Hi students, this is the class for grade 8. In previous class, we have discussed the covering system, and there is two types of covering system: cell wall and cell membrane. Cell wall was discussed in previous video. So in this video, we will discuss about the process of structure of plasma membrane. Structure of plasma membrane or cell membrane, the same word. So what is plasma membrane? First of all, definition. What is plasma membrane? Plasma membrane presents in all type of cell, like cell wall. Cell wall only presents in some prokaryotic cells and plant cell, but animal cell does not contain the cell wall. But plasma membrane presents in each and every type of cell. Any kinds of cell contain the plasma membrane. In case of plant cell, that is presents just beneath the cell wall. It is plasma membrane. And where the cell wall is absent, then the outermost covering is known as plasma membrane. So what would be the definition of plasma membrane? The plasma membrane, the thin, flexible, semi-permeable layer presents just beneath the cell wall, or in case of animal cell, the outermost covering, that is known as plasma membrane. It is mainly composed with protein and lipid. There is different kinds of model that was discovered by different scientists, but the mostly acceptable model of plasma membrane or cell membrane, that is done by Singer and Nicholson. So what is the model of plasma membrane? This model is known as fluid mosaic model. Fluid mosaic model. Why it is known as fluid mosaic model, I will say you later. First of all, what is the structure of plasma membrane? Now, in this fluid mosaic model, according to this model, or according to any kinds of scientists, they have said that plasma membrane is made up with protein and lipid, and protein have at the outside, means the outer layer. This is protein. And in this side there is also protein. So at the both side there is protein. And in between these two sides protein, means here is protein and here is protein. And in between these, there is lipid. It is the lipid layer. So this model is structure of plasma membrane is also called PLP. PLP model also. Why? Because there is two outer side that is covered by protein, and in between there is lipid. So this is also called PLP, means protein lipid protein model. So the structure of plasma membrane. The plasma membrane is mainly made up with protein and lipid. Proteins are present the two surface outer side of the plasma membrane, and between the two layer of protein there is the lipid, and lipid have also two layers. Lipid have these are lipids. So lipids have the structure like this. It is called head and it is called tail. Head and tail. Head are positive in charge and tails are negatively charged. Heads are positively charged and tails are negatively charged. Why? Because proteins, we are know proteins are made up with amino acid, and amino acid is always positively charged, negatively charged. So protein is negatively charged. So protein is negatively charged and head is positive. So heads are attached with the protein, positive and negative. Attraction occurs, positive and negative end. So there is both heads are attached with protein and tails are negatively charged, so they are belonging here. Why? This is a gap. You can see these are the gap. Why? Because both are tail and both are negatively charged and the same charge repels each other. So, and that's why plasma membrane is flexible. The elasticity occurs due to this gap. When you get pressure hit, then it's come. You can, you have said the magnet. If you, the same end, means north pole and north pole, you come, means it is a magnet. And it is a magnet. If it is north pole and it is north pole, then it is repulse each other. Right, when we press it, then it can come together, but as far you release the pressure, it's taken off. Then same function occurs here. That's the flexibility. That's why it is flexible. There is a special structure in plasma membrane, that is the glycoprotein. It is called glycoprotein. Glycoprotein. You can see there is two names, glycoprotein. Glyco means glycogen, that is a carbohydrate, and protein. So glycogen and protein mixed with each other to produce this structure, that is glycoprotein. That head, that is glycogen, that is made up with glycogen, and that this part, the lower part, that is made up with protein. You can see better fully here. The structure is like that and. So this portion is made up with glycogen, and this is made up with protein. It is attached with each other and produce the glycoprotein. Why it is formed? Because when it is attached with each other, then it is blocked. Nothing can pass through it. But when it is detached from the head, means it is detached. The head is detached. Then it make a channel in the protein part. It make a channel in the protein part. Like this. The head is off. That's why, look at this. There is a gap produced between the protein, and through this gap, any materials can transport from one cell to another cell. I repeat, the glycoprotein have the ability to detach, glycogen detach from protein. And when it occurs, then a channel produced through which any materials, any substance from one cell to another can passes through. And that's why it is important. So, and for this reason, the plasma membrane is also known as semi-permeable membrane. Means any kinds of materials does not pass, which get the permission of pass, then that materials can go from one cell to another. But which do not get the pass, you will not pass. So it is known as semi-permeable membrane. So I repeat in shortly the structure of plasma membrane. Plasma membrane mainly made up with protein and lipid, and the proteins are outside of lipid layer, in both side of the lipid layer, and lipids are present just between the two protein layer. The lipid has two part, that is head and tail. Head is positively charged and tail is negatively charged. So the heads are attached with the protein in both sides and tails are in the same side. As per both are negatively charged, so they repulse to each other, and that's why membrane get the flexibility. In next, there is present glycoprotein. Glycoprotein just presents over the protein and lipid layer and it floats over the membrane. It's not fixed here. It can move and it's move throughout the membrane. It is a cell and it is a plasma membrane. So think it is the protein, glycoprotein it is, the hair, it can move throughout the layer. There is many glycoproteins and they are rotate, and as per they are rotate, where the requirement of transportation, they are affixed and take off the glycogen part and pass the desired materials. And when it does not require the any kind of transportation, then they are floating over and nothing can pass through the plasma membrane. So it is also known as semi-permeable membrane. So this is the classes of plasma membrane. So today we finish the part of covering system of cell. In before class we have discussed cell wall, and in this class I have discussed the plasma membrane. The role of plasma membrane, that it give and shape and size to the cell, it protect the cell from different kinds of attack by antigens, and it helps in transportation desired materials because it is semi-permeable membrane. In next class we will discuss about the different cell organelle of the cell, like nucleus, mitochondria, etc. Anything, a lot of Golgi bodies, lysosome, ribosome. Okay, in each class I will demonstrate the main part of cell organelle.